coming in hot like an asteroid! Greetings, ladies and gents, and welcome to this week's show. I'm your host for this evening, Sean Sational. I'm joined here by Todd Riffick, and new to the panel, for good.
It doesn't matter.
Forever.
It doesn't matter. Star's here already, bro. Star's right here.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Some girl.
Tracy Hot! All right. All right.
What's today's topic?
That's right. I forgot why I was here. Our topic today is, what series can substitute for Game of Thrones until the prequel, what is that, the prequel series called The Long Night?
I'm going to go ahead and get started.
By all means, please.
Nothing can substitute Game of Thrones.
Besides that.
Except for this new webisode series coming out soon called Morbid Saint.
Oh, stay tuned for that. It's going to be starring some very, very important people.
Unbelievable. Some guy named Todd Riffick.
Yeah. But,
and Sean Stational.
I was gonna keep that one up, but cool.
Zing.
Alright, so really, you can't really substitute one of the greatest series of all time. I know it had a disappointing last season, but nonetheless, it is one of the best series you have ever seen. You know, hands down, as an overall project. Were you hot over there, bro?
We're not going to talk about the ending.
Yeah. There's extra heat in this panel.
You alright?
It's so close.
It's hot. It's hot when Tracy Hot is here.
That's exactly. Alright. She's on fire tonight. We got this rolling.
Okay, so I'll start off with the first one to get this done. We're finally going to get on with the show. American Gods. It's a good substitution. No, you're not. Jesus.
Yes.
Really?
It's pretty good.
It is. It's a great show.
A few episodes so far.
I like it.
Yeah, it's a very, very strange show, but it...
Not like Preacher strange.
But it is a great show, especially when you like that fantasy kind of like god, you know, like Game of Thrones. They had that fantasy, has some gods in it, but it's like more of a modern thing. It's got me on edge. Like, I want to know what happens next. There's a lot of things going on, and I'm like, man, like, what is going on right now? Like... It's going to start rolling. I feel like something's bigger is coming along, and I recommend it. I recommend The American Gods. But that's all I got to say about that.
I think it's a great show. I agree.
Have you seen it?
A little bit.
Here's the thing, though. Like, I'm going to be very careful about what I say for now, because I ruined Breaking Bad for you.
Yeah,
and
he did.
I still feel bad about it.
I'm happy he does. I hope he takes it to the grave.
Well,
you
know what, Sean?
No, I'm only joking. You've inspired me to finish it. That's what
good.
It is. Because you know, I like to know the endings.
Yeah, you
sometimes.
Do. Sometimes.
Yellowstone.
I've not seen that yet.
I like it. It's Kevin Costner. Yeah, it's pretty much Godfather on a ranch.
Oh.
It's cool.
I like Kevin Costner.
I love it. There's a lot. You know, I think you'll recognize a few of the other actors on there. But yeah, it's pretty much, that's all I gotta say, it's the Godfather on a ranch.
It's a Handmaid's Tale, and it's pretty rough for guys to watch, but if, you know, you guys can sit down and watch it, it's actually a really well-written show. It's got an awesome story, it's gonna keep you, like, biting your nails, and just, like, kind of waiting to, like, hit play next on the next episode. It's about, kind of like, maybe sort of futuristic, but, like, in the very close near future, as you watch the show, it's gonna... kind of hit you. It's so hot in here. It's so hot. It's gonna hit you like, man, this could actually really happen, you know what I mean? It's they take all the fertile females and they kind of round them up and use them to like legitimately make babies for like the powerful that are like remaining in the country. So like
it's like the beginning
struggle.
Of Mad Max.
Oh, that's right.
It's not.
Yeah, he has the room
not.
Full of women that
coming
just makes
from
babies.
Men.
No, but not only they're pumping the breast milk, right?
Yeah, they're pumping the breast milk.
It's the finest. It's actually the most nutritious for humans, anyway.
Jesus, no, it's not.
It is. Yeah,
totally.
You like sucking on another animal's milk and teat?
No, it's not like hiring like.
I think we're
like,
getting
getting hired. They're not getting paid. They're like they're in slave labor. It's about
like
the
Mad Max.
The reiteration of slave labor in like a new America they call Gilead. And it's crazy because, you know, you can run away to Canada and all this kind of stuff. I'm not going to ruin anything about the story, but, I mean, if you can sit down and watch it, like, female or male, like you're going to, I think you're going to really enjoy it. It's super powerful and it's kind of difficult to watch it sometimes, but it's continuously entertaining. And I can't wait until
the next
episode.
That sounds a lot more graphic and interesting than the original. So I will definitely be tuning in. Go ahead. It's in order, right?
Well,
okay.
I'll go again. Yeah. Okay. So I haven't seen any of these series, any episodes of this series yet, only because it hasn't come out yet. But I am really excited to watch The Boys, or Boys.
He likes to watch Boys.
God, you're stupid.
He's excited, he said.
What? I'm just kidding.
You would take it there. Thanks a lot. Hey, going on.
You're so disgusting. I was talking about the damn series.
I'm talking about Boys, the series.
You grotesque me.
It has Carl Urban on it, and you know what? Here, just take this, and you just leave.
We're just here.
Yeah. Anyways, it's a series with
What is it? What was it? Superheroes, right?
Yes, it's about superheroes that are getting big egos. It's like what happens if DC characters or Marvel characters was real and they got a big head from fame. And so there's this group of people called the Boys, or Boys, and they basically keep superheroes in check.
That's cool.
So they start eliminating superheroes.
Because
the superheroes are starting, as far as what I've seen, it is from the same guy who wrote The Preacher. So it's going to be graphic, it's going to be like very, and I'm glad it's on an Amazon Prime or a Netflix kind of streaming, because it will be there's no rules, you know
uncensored.
What I mean? It'll be very uncensored.
Dude, what the hell, man?
What's wrong?
You touched my leg.
That was just my hat. I'm going to go with Killing Eve. Yes. It stars Sandra Oh and the fantastic... the remarkable,
beautiful
Jodie Comer. Hopefully I'm seeing your name right. So anyway, yeah, so she, Sandra Oh plays an MI5 agent, and she's hunting down this, like, assassin, this killer, right? One of the best. And that's Villanelle, who's played by Jodie, right? So it's an interesting movie. It's really a dark, dark comedy.
Allez, tu vas y arriver.
You chose that that photo?
Oh, God! Someone!
Squealer. You want to stay and watch a movie?
No, I can't. I'm sorry.
Wow, you look amazing. Can I take a picture of you for my Instagram?
No. No, of course not. Don't be pathetic. Get a real life.
I had to use my tits.
To kill him?
What are you doing?
Happy birthday!
How wonderful to see you.
Okay, lift me.
No, I'm at the best show. No!
Hablas español?
Sí.
I don't need to feel this. I will see you tomorrow.
Butcher?
Yeah.
Like you shot Frank! Bang! In the head!
Putain quoi?
You don't know that one, do you?
Because Villanelle is so hilarious.
Thank you.
While she's committing these, you know, assassinations and murders, sometimes she just murders because she wants to. But in this cat and mouse kind of story, both are kind of infatuated. Well, first Sandra Oh becomes infatuated because that's the kind of MI5 agent she is, hunting her down, learning, you know, actually almost having some kind of obsession with her target, trying, you know, because she has to get into the mind, into everything that Villanelle is, so she can catch her. But while that's going on, Villanelle is actually falling for Eve, who's played by Sandra Oh, the MI5 agent, and is actually, you know, developing feelings in this weird obsession herself. So they're kind of going back and forth, teaming up, trying to kill each other. It's crazy. It's absolutely bonkers.
Shut up! I'll blow your tiny head to pieces!
My dad is going to kill you in the face!
No, I'm going to kill your dad in the face.
No! Why?
Because he is an arsehole.
You can't say shit about my
dad! I can!
You can't!
Why are you shouting?
I will kill you!
I will kill you!
I know you showed me a couple of, like, scenes of it, and it looked pretty interesting. It'd be definitely
it's crazy.
Alright, so there's another series that has not been released yet. I'm really excited about because it takes place after, you know, everything in the original like comic book or movie. This is Watchmen. So we get to see what happens after all the events of Watchmen from the comic books or movie come out, and how the society has moved on from the big events of what happened with Dr. Manhattan and everything. So I've always been a big fan of the Watchmen series. It's always been a great, well-written book.
It was a cool movie too.
Yeah, very cool movie. A very underrated movie.
For sure.
Yeah, very, very underrated movie.
I wanted the squid at the end. The monster. Oh. The Godzilla thing.
I was like, oh, is that a
movie? He's like, are you watching the right movie? Like, we're not talking about Godzilla versus the king of monsters.
But no, it's like, it's a really good show. Like,
is it based off of the movie or the comic
book? That I'm not sure. Oh. Like I know that the comic.
I think we'll have to wait and see.
I know that the comic book. I know the comic book.
Don't touch the precious.
I know the comic book, and I'm never gonna get my show done.
You never get your show done.
That is Todd Riffick's show.
No, it's not my show, but you know, it's
but
my turn.
But Watchmen.
Yeah, Watchmen.
Why does everything have to do with boys or men? Why do you gotta watch men though? What else do you have on here?
Where's your mind at? In the gutter over here.
I think they've all lost their minds.
I think both of you lost your minds.
I'm surprised you're not a streamer.
What am I doing?
Oh my God.
But I love it.
Oh yeah.
Watchmen.
I'm in Japan though. It's hot here in Hawaii, you guys. It's hot.
It is.
It's real hot.
I'll go with Warrior.
It's
based off of the original Bruce Lee. Scripts for what was supposed to be the original Kung Fu, but they didn't go in that direction. They went with David Carradine they went a whole nother way in the Western universe. But this one is still in that time period, but it really the story follows the war between the Tongs, which are kind of like your dons or your crime bosses of that time period. And it's pretty cool. You know, watching it, there's a lot of beats of dragging the Bruce Lee story mixed with Kung Fu, the series, and like that whole gangster thing. So yeah, it's pretty cool. I like it.
I have my list.
I really like it.
I haven't seen it yet. It is on my favorites to watch. I'm watching, trying to keep up with all the other stuff that people are telling me to watch.
The one thing I like about that one is it takes its time. Like Yellowstone, and I notice a lot of series nowadays. And I understand why they do it, because they don't know if they're going to get renewed. Right. But like they throw everything at you, the kitchen sink, and you don't have a time to breathe, you know. And it's like every episode is like world ending, you know. Yeah. It's just like, oh man, my heart can't take it, my mind can't take it, you know. I was just like, damn.
Barefoot is the
anymore?
Show.
Anymore?
I think
Stranger Things. You guys already know.
Yeah, Stranger Things. Yeah.
Harlots.
What the fuck is that?
Stranger Things.
Harlots is like it's like prostitutes in the 18th century or early 19th
century. I remember you telling me about
it. It's pretty crazy. Like they're all backstabbing each other. It's like the war.
So if you want an opposite of The Handmaid's Tale, check out Harlots.
Yeah, for guys who just want to watch. But I mean, it's a. I know, like some people might take it the wrong way because.
It's good.
Oh, you seen it?
No.
I'm happy. She just agreed.
Supporting you.
She's fantastic. So, Todd, get the hell out of here.
I'm just supporting you.
Guess what? That's it for this week's show. We are out.
Oh, I'm supposed to do that?